our Zona 1 today. After a pretty unfortunate death in Thanatos Tower last time. So we're gonna try to make up for that by just making it through. And it's not gonna go well, I'll tell you that right now. Obviously, we have to get back in here. I'm just gonna mash through. Just kind of mash through all a lot of the dialogue. Because we've already seen it all. Especially in this first room. We'll go with the same thing of locking Yukino's persona. And then just kind of rushing through. Really, our first goal here is to get to Tartarus, just on the second floor. And from there, we'll spend a lot of time in Tartarus, actually. We're gonna put a little bit of focus on ranking up our personas too, just to kind of make things easier. But this is where we're gonna start seeing like a really big level difference between certain characters appear. And of course we're going to try to minimize the amount of like other character deaths. It's pretty much if our other characters are dying, we're putting ourselves in a really bad position. I don't know how well it's going through here. I'm gonna listen to a compilation of the SMT battle themes. These songs are pretty freaking good. Might even be a little too loud. Just turn it down just a hair. Just so that it like barely comes through. I'm not trying to fight the microphone for it. So we lost Brown, and we lost Pump, so we're in kind of a bad position here. This is going to make it a lot harder to just get through this first floor for sure. But it isn't impossible, it's just a little difficult. Pretty sure I make it on this try. And then the characters who lose their personas are just going to be using guns a lot. Gun. The point of that is really just to, like, give them some damage. Except for Yukino, who doesn't have a gun. So she's just going to keep throwing her knives. It contributes a lot to the level difference because their contribution is going to be a lot less. They're going to gain a lot less experience pretty naturally. This is pretty straightforward. The first floor is actually not long. It's just a little maze-like, so it's easy to get lost, and it's very dangerous because of this whole thing. So doing a little like research in hindsight, something that I figured out from like the speedrunners is that Mabufu is actually like pretty broken, I guess. I guess it's a really like buff spell. So I don't know, I think in Snow Queen Quest it's a little less so, but it's probably something I definitely didn't utilize as well as I probably could have. These Yaxinis give me a little bit of trouble whenever I see them. Cause there's a couple times where I almost die to them. I think even later there's a bunch of times where I just actually die to them. Then these, I don't know what they are, Sarasvatis, Parvati's, whichever one. The chick with the sitar. They also give me a lot of trouble. So this is going to be something that happens a lot in this dungeon, is just like, I'm going to be getting totally shit on, and then I'm just going to start talking to them to try to like end the fight without having to try to kill them. It's going to save me from like inadvertently like getting game overs a couple times, and it's gonna just save me a lot of damage. But mostly it'll happen when I'm down to just Ellie. It is I think a good strategy to do in this dungeon, because you're gonna run into a lot of issues. It works pretty well. I mean, like, it worked pretty well there. And I'm gonna do it a little bit more as we go on. I'm gonna be underleveled to actually get cards, which is part of, like, how it works when you do the talking. Is just so you just talk to them just to get them to leave, pretty much. You know, take items, take money. Money is definitely not an issue in this run, especially given all the grinding that I ended up doing. But items here and there. So this is Cerberus. He's the guardian of Tartarus, which is where we're gonna go to get our personas back. It's pretty much the realm of like dead souls. Something like that. Story. So he pretty much just says, like, if you want to go in, then go in. You know, but you don't belong there. So we're just going to go in. Because he's out to you. I don't know why I said no there. I think I was like kind of making sure this is where I wanted to be. So there's going to be a few things of note in Tartarus. The first is going to be a room that we're going to right now, which is going to be where we get our personas back when they're locked. You just go in there, and there'll be some mirrors and reflections of characters. And when you go in there and interact with the mirrors, you'll gain character's persona back. And then there's going to be 4 mirror shards in here. And since we're going out to get all the mirror shards, this is a pretty important place to be. So but we are going to have to deal with all 4 of my party members not having access to personas right now. So I do know for sure once I make it to the room that I'm looking for. It's gonna be the end of this VOD. I'm actually just gonna go ahead and see if I can't get the next one ready. While this is finishing up. Oh frick, I don't know which one it is. Did it end? I don't know. Oh, oops. Okay, well that's gonna be the end of this video then.